I know it's weird not seeing Big D in Winners Finals.
We have Captain L, you know.
The reigning champion of BBR.
And we have a challenger in Len, who eliminated Big D from the winner's side of the bracket in the semis.
And a score that I believe was 2-0.
Hell, boy.
You know, I've been really impressed with Len's play lately. He's been doing really well for himself. And,
I was really sad that he didn't enter last week. He could have won the event.
Well, you know how weenies do.
Nah, he just really wanted to watch Genesis.
No.
That's why I said he didn't enter. Anyway, Layden's got a little bit of a lead right now. So, This matchup's dumb. This matchup is basically whoever gets first stock is going to be at a huge advantage.
Yeah. Sounds like
Pikachu has like a bit better options overall for ending a stock.
Yo, shout outs to Red Bull chicks.
Oh man,
y'all look very nice right now.
Come back this way, because I want a Red Bull.
Yo, I want to play Smash 64 right now. Yo, where's the 64 bracket at?
Yeah, yo, long. 64 next time? BBR3? Oh, we just got the go ahead. Shout out to 64. We're having a BBR3.
Is Long going to make it happen?
You just said so. I heard a rumor that BBR3 may have a guest.
What is Long saying?
It's okay.
Captain L with the first stock here in winners.
Yep.
Finals.
Winners finals. BBR number two.
A second. The repeat.
The stock. This game is even. That was the worst thing that could have happened for Captain L.
I think the worst thing that could have happened is him SDing his hero twice.
That would probably be the worst thing.
That's probably the worst thing.
That was the worst case scenario of what just occurred, though. He didn't.
I'm gonna drink the microphone.
Take it in, buddy.
Take it in.
Now, this is why this matchup's so dumb. It's just, I hit you with a button. It's gonna link to all these other buttons. She's like, Sheik is the opposite of what fighting games are supposed to be about, which is not hitting buttons. Down tilt. Side bet? I heard side bet. So both players, 80%. I'd say at this point it's a lot easier for Landon to win this match than Len, simply because Pikachu can up smash and up throw thunder. Or Sheik is at that almost to the percent where she can only deal with down throw up air. I'll take a sugar free. Thank you.
Okay.
Definitely shout out to the Red Bull.
Shout out to the Red Bull chicks. Shout out to Red Bull and the homies. Okay.
This is going to be a problem for Len now. Because
down
throw vanish is no longer going to work. He's going to have to connect down throw up air. And because of that, Pikachu can jump away.
Dude, oh no. Okay, I was just about to say, Pikachu's neutral, like the moves that he can use as neutral, are a lot stronger and can kill a lot better than what she can. Right?
Well, yeah.
So what you want to do is you want to just fight Captain L in particular in neutral, right? Until he flubs, because in the position he was in, he had nothing to lose by not approaching him. They were both in the same position, and honestly, like from a mindset perspective, you're gonna be looking at like Captain L. He's been here and he's won tournaments. Like he's been around the block, right? Len's on the come up.
Yeah.
Right. What he wants to do is he wants to push the dude that's quote unquote better than him as far as he can go, right? He wants to find the breaking point, he wants to crack it, and that's what he's expecting, and the set is gonna be.
And I know Len has won sets against Captain L in the past.
He can do this.
I don't think he's done it with Sheik though.
Sheik, and in the position he's in winner's finals, that's big news, you know?
Forward air and a bouncing fish. One of the many instances that she can combo into anything she wants at almost any percent.
Yo, Jake!
Shout out to Jake Turner.
Shout out to Jake Turner. Firefly, the greatest Yoshi I've ever seen in my life.
He's number one in our heart. And he is Jake number one. There he is. Catch him at the vanish. But good DI.
I'm Jake 2.0 here.
Technically, I'd be the original. I'm older.
Yeah? But you didn't exist until you started playing Smash.
I started playing Smash before he did.
Oh, jeez.
I'm from Ontario.
No, I want some more fucking Red Bull. I'll take some more.
Oh, you didn't go to Drop Zone, did you?
No, I didn't.
Dude, do you know any Red Bull I brought home from Drop Zone?
No.
Yo, can I get another?
Oh, just louder. Huh? Up air. Takes it. Land in a nice little lead here. In game two. Counter City. Down throw is an interesting option at that point. Seems to me like he's trying to keep up a throw fresh for a kill. Flagging them. They're just trying to watch winners finals. And you're.
I'm sorry. Can I get it on? Swag. Okay. More shout outs to the Red Bull chicks. We got more Red Bull on Red Bull.
Are you gonna get her number by the end of the day?
What's that?
You gonna get her number by the end of the day?
Maybe I should. Which one?
I don't know.
They're both fucking cute. You know what else is fucking cute? Len Shi.
I wanted you to just end it with Len. Just end it with Len.
Yo, Len's the sexiest. Look, he's so fucking scruffy. I love him.
Yo, would you believe he just graduated high school?
Yo, really?
Yeah.
Does that mean he's legal?
I met Len, I thought he was like third year university.
Do you know that fucking Captain L is like 100? Like, that dude is so old.
I'm older than him.
Yeah, so what? He's like 20, he's 23, right? 22?
He's like
man. My age.
That means you're old.
Yeah, I'm an old man. I'm sorry.
I'm a really old man.
I've been playing this game for like 8 years. Not this one, but Melee.
I played Melee back in the good old days, and then I stopped. I regret stopping.
Yeah, you should. But you're playing now, though, right?
I don't have anyone real way of practice, because I never really see Nathan.
Are you coming over? Are you going to live with me?
No! I work downtown! The jabs are dumb.
Yo, this is close as fuck, but Captain L can like close out this game
up the row,
and make the set look a lot harder for Len. You know what I mean? And on the flip side, if Len can get himself on the board, this shit's gonna be like 1,000 times more like hard.
Oh! What the hell? Yo, is that a level 9 Sheik?
Yo! That was some shit! Oh my god, okay, 1-1. Len's on the board. Alright? People are fucking losing it. Yo, okay, Len's,
you know who's
fucking
losing
real,
it?
Man.
No, Len's legitimate.
Len's so fucking good.
And the best part about Len is he's the only person on our PR who's not a Brawl veteran.
Oh shit, yeah.
Like, Smash 4 is the first Smash game he played competitively.
So let me tell you guys, most of the people that are on the PR and play Smash 4 currently in British Columbia are Brawl rats, okay? They came from an older time when Brawl was the main game in BC. It was actually bigger than Melee for a bit.
All except for Mata, who's actually from California.
That's a cheater.
Hey, he was one of the top Pokemon trainer players.
Okay, all right then. So everybody.
Yeah.
They all played
Brawl. It's not necessarily
Brawl.
From BC, but yeah, it's pretty...
They all played Brawl.
They all played Brawl.
With the exception of Len, apparently. And this guy's coming in fresh.
And when he came into our scene, he was a Dr. Mario main.
So, okay. So the thing that makes it significant about these Brawl players is that they have previous experience with spacing and tournament pressure. You know what I mean? So having all of that and going into a game like Smash 4 gives them a bit of an advantage. You know, it really does.
And in a lot of ways, a lot of the things that might work in Brawl will work in Smash 4.
Yeah.
But the big thing is the change from, say, Melee to Smash 4 or even Melee to Brawl is not nearly as big as from Brawl to Smash 4.
Yeah, okay.
So all the players who did play Brawl had the advantage as well of Bouncing Fish being a stupid move. But
Len didn't have that kind of experience going into this game.
Yeah.
Yet, he's here.
And his first tournament was last year.
Wow, incredible. Big D has been playing this game forever.
Yeah.
He's been playing Smash Brothers for a long time, and he's a great player. Excellent. And he's been beaten out by Len here. And that's just such a significant win in my book. That's,
oh, yeah. I really want to try and get Len to come down to Evo.
Captain L. Saying what's up.
Gets the taunt in there.
You know.
Captain L's feeling it.
You know, yo, I see Sion. Shout outs to my boy.
Are you going to be playing Sion in Grand Finals? You're winner's side, though, right?
Yeah. And then I'm going to let it go to set 2, game 5. Last one. 130%.
You're going to let it.
I'm going to let it. You'll see.
How does Falco get to 130%?
Watch. My DI, son. Yo, this is a significant game, man. This shit's important.
Game.
The winner of this gets counterpick advantage for game 5. Len does not need to put any additional pressure right now. He needs to keep himself from getting caught up in Captain L's follow-up.
I don't know. I think the winner of this set, or the winner of this match, wins the set.
Okay.
Either Len is going to steal all the momentum after starting, you know, 0-1.
Or Captain L's
going
to clutch.
Or Captain L is going to clutch it out, and he's going to be entering that. This is a big tournament.
And I'm a win.
Captain L, the last two quote-unquote big tournaments for BBR and the EXP finals, Captain L won both of them.
Over Big D, yeah.
So Big D still, like, has the big rain on all of our locals. But when there's clutch, we have, like, these big 50-man brackets.
Landon
is prepared to step it up.
I think right now, one of the biggest concerns on both of these players' minds isn't really, oh, I need to win right now. Is,
yeah.
If I lose here, I have to play Big D. That's a fucking scary thought to be having, you know what I mean? And when the set is this close, you know, that's a very real possibility for both of these players. I'm going to have to beat Big D before Grand Finals if I want to win this tournament.
Yeah. Both of these players are thinking, I only want to have to beat Dawson once.
Exactly. Exactly. Len's already put in his dues, you know?
Oh! Oh! Yeah.
Len is...
Dash Attack won't kill just yet, but it's pretty
dude,
nice.
Dude, that was swag, though.
Oh, no.
Yo!
If he gets it...
Yup!
So, down throw up air. Pretty sure that's guaranteed at that point. Because Captain L's gonna know he's never gonna be in position to be hit by Vanish at that point. So.
That was scary.
Len takes a bunch of momentum, winning 2 straight. Captain L takes off the headphones.
Yo, Captain L's serious.
He doesn't want to play Big D. I mean, obviously he's gonna have to play Big D one way or the other, but he wants it to be.
Assuming Big D wins.
Yeah.
He loses finally. But she's going to have to beat the dude that's
ending. That's what I'm saying. If Lane is thinking, I don't want to play Big D now. He'd rather have a full set to work with.
Two of them.
That's going to be like a whole set, and then he can go back into, okay, now my tournament's on the line.
Lane's playing beautifully.
Yeah. He's doing exactly what you're saying. Like, don't crush the issue. There it is.
Yo! Captain L!
The down air was what surprised me. I would have expected a fully charged forward smash.
Probably
like after the down air, it looked like he was going for a reset. That was a great power shield. Like that power shield just saved his life. That was amazing.
I fucking hate that jab.
Yeah. But No, after the town air, he looked like he was going to reset it again. So maybe he thought that there was more stage. I don't know if down air can cause a jab reset. If it can, he'll screw Pikachu.
I'm sure he was going for something else.
If you went down air to another jab reset in an F smash, like, that would have been the, like, most ridiculous Pikachu thing I would have ever
seen.
Did
you see that shit kill? That was nasty.
Yeah.
Dash attack? Is that a baby Skull? Is that tackle?
That was the original Skull Bash before custom.
I thought Skull Bash was side B.
Yeah, no. His custom Sky B was heavy Skull Bash. Wow. And it killed at like 40.
But like, no customs, right?
No customs. What customs?
I don't know anything.
All in all, this is a really good game for Captain L.
We need more Red Bull cans.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
That was long. We need more Red Bull. We need, like, a platform for Red Bull.
See, this is why this matchup and, like, the Sheik Ditto is so... And I hate using the term, but it's so volatile. Landon got the lead. He's camping... Like the man we all said he once was. But he now has a... He now has a book on land.
Yo, Red Bull. Red Bull cam, please. Long. Pikachu. Red Bull, sick.
Red Bull.
We're looking at Red Bull. Shoutouts.
Shoutouts to Red Bull.
So we're here at Vancouver Battle Royale.
Did you see how Captain L ended that game?
Yeah, he was sick nasty.
That was, like, that's a book. Like, the read, he...
Captain L is a disgusting player. There's a reason he's consistently in these winners' finals, you know? The
true.
Dude is great. He's an excellent player.
You know what?
And he's done his dues, you know?
Oh, yeah, he was the bridesmaid for so long.
Only second place?
Oh, yeah.
Second place curse. For a while, it was always him and me getting second place at most of the events we'd entered.
And then he was the first one to, like, ever beat Big D, especially, I think, in this game. I'm sure he wasn't always just dominating Brawl as well, but...
We got us a Red Bull. We got picks. We got
We did. Now, that's something I know Len has been wanting to do more, because we talked about this last week during Genesis. He's going to throw up more nairs. The Sheik's Nair is really good, but nobody in PC really uses it.
Did Len get a Genesis?
No.
I thought the whole thing there. I thought I saw it.
No, there was Cantrip, Captain L, Focus.
Yep!
That man was definitely there. Big D and Firefly. I was supposed to go, but hospital. But we're going to Evo, so it's all good. I know there are at least two other players from BC that were at Genesis, but those were the five PR players that went. This set, for all intents and purposes, is Captain L's to lose.
But
he's got a sizable lead, and he never has to die. Like, we know Captain L is fine with camping and timing UL.
Was that a choke? Shouldn't he have down throw into up air? Yup, there you go.
Down throw up air wouldn't have connected.
Ew,
there.
Dude, this is so close.
Yeah. It's still going to be easier for Landon to end this match though.
Yo,
especially
Landon,
if the confirms that he's getting are simply forward throw into bouncing fit.
Yo, this Sheik is so sexy. I think I have a new favorite Smash 4 player.
Len?
Dude, Len's Sheik is like what
it's really
what I
good.
Want to see. It's what I want to see in a Sheik. Like, the movement is just so... I love it. Got a hit with the shield poke there, though. And Captain L throwing out the hitboxes.
Yeah, Captain L's playing a really good game of pussies right now.
Ouch. His pressure. His pressure is phenomenal.
Yeah, for a guy who's like... There's no reason to approach. The pressure that Captain L is just exerting right now.
It's part of the reason that he's so intimidating to play against, right? He's so in your face. Like, he's present, but he stays so safe. Shout out to Getty Shield after this. Sneaks under. Hits him with the up tilt.
Landon really wants to just reset the distribution from there. Doesn't want to get caught by anything like that. Stage control is so important right now.
Len is playing very aggressive.
He is, and the reason for it is, you know, Pikachu, if Pikachu's at the edge of the stage, he can die to a bouncing fish at any time.
I suppose. Oh, is that it?
A great punish. Punishing the Rapid Jab with the up smash. Captain L wins it. Game 5. We'll be awaiting the winner of Len versus Big D.